So, something that I'm curious about is co-working. So I've had such amazing co-working opportunities in the last, let's call it, year. I started before I left Montreal. I'm a digital nomad now. I've been since June of this year. I started an indie hackers
Cool.
meetup
It's really cool when you say, and by the way, and by the way, and
Oh
you
yeah,
still know
me
it.
too. No, it's a lot of fun. It's my wife and I.
Yeah,
We're on the
it's really
road.
cool. Yeah.
But I've had amazing co-working opportunities. So before I left Montreal, I started an indie hackers meetup, and I co that's how I met Mark LG, my co-host. And yeah, I met a bunch of people and I've co-worked with a lot of them. And now I've been living in Victoria, British Columbia, and the co-working space on that is amazing. Like, we're throwing work back and forth. We've really created an
Yeah,
awesome,
that's
like,
great. Yeah.
what's your experience been like with co-working? Like, what is your daily setup? Are you working at home? Are you co-working? What's up?
My daily setup is here,
Okay.
in the desk where I guess people cannot see it, but I'm basically wake up and work
Sure.
from here. I've tried co-working as well. I'm trying to like keep it as cheap as possible, so that's why I don't do it more often.
Sure.
I'm an extrovert, right? So I get energy by speaking with people.
Yeah.
So the fact that I'm here alone, like the whole day, right? Mostly, like it doesn't help. Like the community really start helping, but because now I have people to talk
Yeah.
and a lot of indie makers as well, and like we have a lot of chats even today. There's people in the community. I was like, hey, let's have a chat about the fractional CTO thing. So it really helps. I first tried doing go. There's a co-working space really nearby here, so I thought, okay, let's go there and check it out. And my experience wasn't great because I got there and most of the people there were startups, so
Okay.
like small startups, because I guess that's how a lot of the co-work spaces make money here. They rent a part of their office to a company,
Yeah, for a fixed term,
for
some
exactly,
minimums.
yeah. So I don't know, I got there and they didn't have like floating desks. They said I maybe can stay in the kitchen. I was like, okay, I was like sitting now in the kitchen and I don't know, I felt awkward.
Sure.
So I thought, okay, maybe I could put a little bit more time into like creating relationships here and like meeting people, but I didn't feel like it. So that one didn't work well. Then I returned and I thought, okay, maybe that's not for me. Then I started like trying out other co-working spaces, and I tried the Now Beato one, with the one that with the crazy vibe, which was cooler. And there's more indie hackers there, so like now I'm in this desk with other people. So I thought, okay, this could be something interesting. And then the other one that I told you also, it's called Idea Space. So definitely, I can see myself doing all of these connections and like being energized by just being around these people. And mostly if I now start getting a little bit more money, this is something that I would like to do.
Sure.
My ideal scenario would be like to have a bunch of indie hacker friends here in the city that we could like always agree to maybe twice, thrice a week, go to this place and work together and then have a beer and then chat and have
So.
like this kind of social life as well around the work. Because like I'm working a lot, right? Like I need the time also to focus. But I also need just like grab a beer and chat a little bit. So that would be my ideal scenario. Plus the networking effect that you just said, it seems really, really exciting.
Yeah. I think of the co-working that I've done, especially in Victoria, the co-working space that I'm in is not necessarily technically focused. There are a few tech companies, but there's a lot of just individual consultants. There's a lot of creatatives. So there's a lot of non-technical people that are looking for help or just looking to have a beer, have a good time. So I wonder if it might just be time invested. Like, maybe you just have to be a familiar face, and then all of a sudden people feel comfortable speaking with you. Because, like, I don't know that I would call myself an extrovert, but my wife is always saying, like, you're making all these friends at the co-working space. I'm becoming our social life of just like the people I'm meeting. So, I mean, as an extrovert, like, you would kill at a co-working space because everybody does want to talk. Like, everybody wants to talk about what's going on and what they're working on, and especially if you're putting yourself in a position to go to a co-working space, you're kind of planting a flag. Like, I'm interested in being with other people.
Mm-hmm.
And people want to talk. They just have to figure out, they just need a nudge.
Yeah.
So like, I imagine you would walk in and destroy. You would meet everybody and everybody would want to talk to you.
Yeah.
I know what you mean though about it feeling a bit awkward, like being stuck in a kitchen and not having like a, you know, a space at a table is a little, that's a little rough.
Yeah, that was not the ideal situation for sure. I mean, yeah, I definitely agree. I think as an extrovert, I think it's like I get energy by speaking with others.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like super. But definitely, I would need some time to be there and start, you know, I'm not the kind of person that will approach someone out of the blue and like, hey, what are you doing?
Mm-hmm.
So I would need like maybe to see the face and start doing that. But yeah, I think it's an interesting situation as well, because I'm so comfortable at home.
Mm-hmm.
So I do go every day to the co-working space.
I have to now, because I, well, especially right now, since we've come to Europe, our Airbnbs are very different. Like,
Right. Is
it going to be comfortable to work in? I really can't sit at a couch and work or a sofa. It just,
right. Yeah,
it just kills my back. So even most co-working spaces, like the chairs need to have a back. And like, if it was adjustable height, that would be amazing. But even that's asking a lot sometimes.
Yeah.
So I'm in co-working spaces pretty much every day.
Okay.
That, and I also love to, I like to separate my workspace from my chill space.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
I mean, that's probably a great idea because I end up spending a lot of time working.
Mm-hmm.
And because, yeah, I just come here and like work during like the night and everything. So
having this
would definitely help. So I think, yeah, I love the concept, to be honest, like to have a space for indie makers and freelancers, everyone working their own thing, but together,
yeah.
You know, in the same area.